face because it's been a year. You've seen it. Okay? You missed me? All right. trig is going to start using the calculators for trig, and they're going to put it into your degree mode on you at some point. So you got to watch your calculator. And if you guys know how to switch the mode, get the home key. I think it's 5 settings, right? And then you want to hit the mode, whatever the angle measure, angle mode to radian. Okay, and then you should get the 0.304. Alright. Then, once you've got it in radian mode, try cosine inverse. Tell me what you get. Basically saying Okay, ready now? Okay, so what happens is we end up seeing these a lot more. This is definitely the B part of the A B. Okay, and it ends up repeating again next year when we take the B C part. We end up seeing them more on the B C than we do the A B. But basically, what this is saying is you have to remember that it's these three that typically pop up: the sine, the tangent, and the secant typically pop up. It's not that the other ones are bad, that they're not fair game, but these are the ones that we can see more often. Okay? Their counterparts basically have a negative on them. Okay? So the sine is the one with the square root of 1 minus u squared. The arctangent is the one without the square root. And the arcsecant has the absolute value of the square root of the function squared minus 1. Okay? Basically, you're going to refer back to the table. Alright, so we're going to look at arc sine. And then remember this little u prime thing. U prime thing is just take the chain rule. Okay? Make sure you take into account the chain rule. So we're going to take this derivative. So I typically do the derivative without the chain rule first. So the main part of the derivative. So arc sine, what's the formula look like? Don't worry about the u prime part, so just go ahead. Square root, right? And then what's in the square root? 1 minus u squared, right? So my u is this chunk in here. So 1 minus 2x squared. And then what's the chain rule give me? 2. So if I can leave it like that, if I cleaned it up, it would be 1 minus 4x squared. You're able to get an arctangent. So, f prime of x equals, so arctangent, don't worry about the u prime part, so then how does this go to the denominator for arctangent? 1 plus u squared, what's my u this time? 3x, okay, and then my chain rule is going to give me 1 minute grade. And again, I can leave it. I can leave it up to 1 plus 9x squared. Alright. Remember, this is kind of like saying x to the 1 half power. We leave that piece. Do the derivative. Arc sine says, what do we put in the denominator? Square root of 1 minus u squared. What's my u this time? Square root of x, right? Okay, and then I got to do the chain rule on this piece, but I'd probably rather look at that. And notice I put times sign that I'm off to the side here. So what do I do with this piece? To the front. So 1 half x to the 1. Negative 1 half power. Good. Now let's clean that up. Okay, I'm going to show you a couple ways the answer can be. Okay? 1's going to remain in the numerator. Is this guy happy where he's at? No. So we would flip him downstairs and put the square root back over here. So that takes care of this whole piece here. Okay, and then we just got this square root of 1 minus x because the square and the square root cancel. Perfectly good answer. However, these guys are both under radical signs, couldn't I distribute that in? I can't distribute the 2 in, but I can distribute the x, so it could be x minus x squared. Yeah, alright, let's look at one that's an arc secant. And there's a lot going on in this one. So, look at your arc secant formula, okay? What's the first part of it say? Absolute value of u, what's the u piece?
U
to the 2x, okay? And then under the square root, what does it say we gotta do?
U squared minus square.
Okay, 2 over, and then I'm going to square this, so when I have a power swap power, I multiply my exponents, so I get e to the what? 4x minus 1. That's probably where I would stop. Alright, we're going to do 2 messages. We're going to do 18 and 19, and I'm not going to do equation tangent, I'm not going to do both. Okay? Let's do 2 messages. Alright, so 18. And this one's not messy because it's the inverse derivative messy because it's the best back here. Okay. Alright, what's the derivative of arc sine? Stay the way it is.